Now we are going to see deletion of node in between in linked list. So this algorithm receives a parameter k which represents key value of the node to be deleted. For example, in this case, if k equal to d, then node to be deleted will be this one. If k equal to a, you have to delete this node. If k equal to b, you may have to delete this node. If k equal to f, you have to delete this node. If k equal to m, what will be the situation? Assume that you have passed m as parameter. That means node to be deleted is not present in the in our linked list. So you have to address all these cases. So you have to check whether node to be deleted in is there in the single linked list or not. If it is not present, you can display the message node does not present, not exist. Otherwise you have to delete that node. So in order to write this algorithm, you need to make use of two pointers. Assume that the first pointer be q, which is initialized to null at first, and the second pointer be p, which is initialized to start. So you can write those steps. First you have to take q, pointer q, and you can initialize it to null. Then you can take pointer p and you can initialize it to start. So you have to iterate it using p. I will mention the purpose of p and q. P actually checks whether or keep track of the node to be deleted. So it will go on iterate until it reaches the node to be deleted if it is present there in the linked list. Otherwise, eventually the value of p will become equal to none. And q actually follows p, and if p is present in the list, q will reach its predecessor. So you need to track the predecessor of exact node to be deleted, then only you can link the predecessor with successor of node to be deleted. Assume that you want to delete g. So as I said, p eventually reaches g and q will reach the predecessor of p. Now what you do is you have to link node referred by q with successor of p. So that is the purpose of maintaining pointer q. Now if q remains null, then you can say that node to be deleted is the first node. Or at the end, if p reaches null, then you can say that such a node or node to be deleted does not present in the linked list, given linked list. So you can start iteration. First you have to ensure that q is not null. So q is not equal to null. If q is not equal to null, while q not equal to null, and what is the next condition to proceed? Sorry, this could be p. So we have to check whether p is not null and p data is not equal to search key. So assume that our search key is g. So we'll be checking p data equal not equal to search key. P data is not equal to search key. Data not equal to k. If this condition is satisfied, you have to shift these two pointers. Shift pointers in the sense, whenever you shift p, q must point to predecessor node of p. So how will you do that operation? First you have to take pointer q, make it point to p. So take q, make it point to p, then take p, shift it to its successor. Through the assignment, p equal to p link. Again you will be checking p not equal to null. P is not null, it is 100. and you will be checking P data not equal to K. P data is B, which is not equal to G. So you will take pointer Q and you will make it point to P, followed by taking the pointer P and you will make it point to its successor using the instruction P equal to P link. Again you will be checking P not equal to none, the condition is satisfied, and you are checking the condition P data not equal to K. P data is now equal to K, which is equal to G. So in this case it will terminate. So what happens if not to be deleted is some L which is not there in the list? It will go on iterating, it will take Q, point to P, take P, move it to its successor, then take Q, move it to P. By checking the condition, you will proceed like this. What is next step? You will be checking P not equal to none, the condition is satisfied, and P data not equal to L. So you will take pointer Q and you will make it point to P and you will shift P to its link. P will now becomes null. So in this case, whenever P reaches null, you can say that the node to be deleted is not there in our linked list. So that is one case. So after exiting from this loop, first you have to check whether node to be deleted is present or not. How will you check that condition? You have to check if P equal to none. So it will go on iterating, and if node is not there in the list, P will eventually become null. And if P equal to null, you can simply display node not present. So what about its else part? Else part in the sense, node is there in the list. So if node is there, it could be the first node or any other node other than first. So if it is first node, what will be the condition? So if it is first node, what you will do is you have to make the pointer start point to the second node. For that, you have to check the condition if Q equal to none. We started iteration from here, Q with null value and P pointing to this node. So what happens if search key is D or not to be deleted is D? After initialization, it will check P not null, it gets satisfied, and it will check P data not equal to D, not equal to K, the value is D. So the condition fails because P data is now D. So it exits from this while loop and it will check whether P equal to none. The condition is not satisfied, so it goes to its else part and it checks whether Q equal to null. If Q equal to null, then that means node to be deleted is the first node. So if the node to be deleted is first node, what should be the action? You have to take pointer start and make it point to second node. How do you perform that operation? You have to load this with base address of second node, which is stored in P link. So through the assignment, start equal to P link, or simply start equal to start link, you can load 100 here. P link is 100, that is assigned to start, which breaks this link and creates this link. So in this way you can check whether node to be deleted is the first node or not. Now you can consider remaining cases. So assume that you want to delete an intermediate node whose value is G. So if this is a case, after whenever this loop terminates, P will become pointer to node containing G and Q will become pointer to predecessor node of P. So here we will be checking P equal to null. P is not null. So it will go to this part. It will check whether Q equal to null. Q is not null. That means you are not going to delete the first node. You are going to delete a node other than first node. So what should be in else part? In else part, you have to link these two nodes. Link predecessor of P and successor of P. How can you create this link? In order to create this link, you have to load Q link with P link, which is 200. Through the assignment, Q link equal to P link. So this assignment actually breaks this link and creates this link. So this case checks whether node to be deleted is the first node. If so, it will update the start. Otherwise, it will link predecessor of the node to be deleted with successor of the node to be deleted. So after executing this instruction or this instruction, you have to, after executing these, any one of these two instructions, you have to free node referred by P. Then only memory allotted to this particular node get deallocated. So if it is start node, you have to update start followed by deallocating the start node, because P will be reference to the start node. If it was an intermediate node, link predecessor node with the successor node of P followed by freeing P. So what happens if you are going to delete the last node? What be the situation? So iteration stops at this point. P will refer to this node. In that case, K value will be equal to F. P will refer to this node and Q will refer to this node. So how will you perform this deletion? Here you will be checking P equal to null. The condition fails. So it will go to else part. Then it checks the condition Q equal to null. Q is not null. Q is 200. So it goes to else part. It will perform the assignment Q link equal to P link. Q link is equal to P link. P link is null. So it will, that will be assigned to Q link. So what happens is this location gets set to null. So either by executing this or this, as I said earlier, it will free P. So free P in the sense it will deallocate memory allotted for node P. So this is a simple algorithm. You just try to work out few examples so that you will become comfortable to implement this deletion operation. Now we can move on to analysis part. What about runtime in performing a deletion operation in a list, single linked list of size n? So in worst case, the node to be deleted will be the last node or the second last node. So in that case, you may have to visit n nodes or n minus 1 nodes respectively, which indicates that runtime will turn to order of n. It can be explained like this. If you consider this particular function or algorithm, these instructions actually takes constant time, but cost of this algorithm is dependent on this iteration. This iteration or length of this iteration is dependent upon number of nodes in the chain. Number of nodes in the chain and the input value f. Assume that node to be deleted is f in this case. So you have to visit all the nodes and reach the last node. Until you reach the last node, then only you can perform deletion. So cost will be order of n in general. capacity.